Welcome to 20 Questions with the NRF Foundation. My name is Harley Finkelstein. I'm the president of Shopify, and I'm incredibly excited and humbled to be recognized on the list of people shaping retail's future for 2024. I'm also really looking forward to sharing what I think is an inside look at how I've built my career in retail. But I think first, let me tell you a bit about Shopify. For those of you that don't know, Shopify is the commerce platform that lets you start, grow, and scale your business. We have been very busy over the last two decades or so building and perfecting our platform. And today we power millions of merchants all over the world. We are the business powering all of your favorite brands, and we're building not only the right features and tools to power commerce today, but we think deeply about the tools that are needed to power the brands in the future, and so that retailers can future-proof their businesses and help shape the future of commerce. All right, so with that done, let's jump into 20 questions. I think the first question for me is, what was my first job? My first job was actually a DJ, believe it or not. I'm Jewish, and when you're a Jewish kid, you go to a lot of bar and bat mitzvahs, and I always thought the best part of these bar mitzvah and bat mitzvah parties was seeing how the DJ could single-handedly change the entire mood and mobilize an entire room. You'd sort of see people go from sitting around eating, you know, chicken dinners to 30 seconds later doing a conga line. I just thought that was magic, and I decided that I wanted to do that. I was 13 years old, though, unfortunately, when I wanted to be a DJ. Nobody would hire me, so I decided to start my own DJ company. And between the age of like 13 and about 21, I DJed more than 500 bar and bat mitzvahs, and it was amazing. All right, second question. How did you get the role you are currently in? The way that I got into Shopify is the same way that I hope people encounter Shopify when they first use our platform. I saw the power of the product. I started using Shopify to sell t-shirts when I was in law school, and I realized that I can make money while in class, which is important to me. I didn't have parents that were able to support me at that time. But I was living in Ottawa, and I met Toby, the founder of Shopify. Well, once I graduated from law school, I became a lawyer. I hated it. I knew that I didn't really want to be a lawyer long term. I actually went to law school to become a better entrepreneur. But having been a Shopify merchant all throughout law school and business school, I decided to call up Toby and told him that I wanted to join Shopify. And I was one of the first people to work at the company here. And I guess the rest is history. I went from being sort of a jack of all trades, Swiss Army knife, to helping build things like Shopify Plus, our enterprise product, the Shopify app ecosystem, and obviously help take the company public with Toby as public company, to being the COO, I think shortly thereafter, and to my role today, which is the president. It's been one hell of a ride, and I'm incredibly grateful for it. Why is retail the industry you picked for your career? I think when I joined Shopify, we really thought about how do we make commerce better for everyone. I really grew up surrounded by entrepreneurs, and the real reality was it was incredibly hard. Although growing up, when I thought about entrepreneurship, it really wasn't around small businesses per se. It was really, or people that were passionate about starting a small business. It was really about survival. Entrepreneurship was this incredible tool for people to survive and to put food on their table. And I really believe that, you know, entrepreneurship is the best way for people to self-actualize and reach their full potential. And I was driven to make that more common, more democratized, more achievable. What if everyone that had an idea for a product or a service was able to commercialize that, was able to sell that product and make a living doing that? And I think ultimately retail is the center of commerce, and that's where we're seeing the most innovation. And I just felt there was no better place for me to do my life's work than in retail. And that's why I wanted to be at Shopify as well. Tell us about an experience you've had you think defines retail. Well, what I think defines retail is right now, especially, is the pace of innovation. What used to be the case is that customers went to retailers. So if you want to buy something at a store, you went to the store at a particular time, you picked up the product on the shelf, you waited in line, you paid with a particular credit card. The retailer dictated to you how you should buy when you were the consumer. That's all been flipped on its head. Today, retailers must go to where the customer is. And when I started in retail, you either were basically building a very clunky online store, or you had to sell on a marketplace that allowed you, I guess, to rent customers from that marketplace. But today, the store is more of an extension of the brand, and it's an opportunity to immerse customers in the brand. Today, I can see an outfit or a piece of clothing that I like on Gymshark's Instagram, and then I can walk into the Gymshark store in London on Regent Street. I can do a workout class there, testing their clothing. I can interact with Gymshark ambassadors at the store. I can walk out, I can see that outfit on TikTok, and then I can buy directly from my phone. That is an incredibly immersive experience where every touch point with the brand feels like you're integrating and you're interacting with Gymshark, whether it's online or it's offline or it's everywhere in between. And that's the future of retail, retail everywhere. What career advice would you give to your younger self? I think the career advice I would give to my younger self is to know what you are best at the world at or want to be best at the world at and focus on that. Hire for everything else with people that are better, faster, smarter than you at that thing. I think a lot of companies, a lot of people try to be well-rounded where they want to be very good at a bunch of different things. And I think a better way to approach your career is to figure out what is your sharp point and over time sharpen that point, but be really self-aware of things you're not good at and let other people help you with those things rather than becoming a jack of all trades, become a master of one and be the best in the world at that thing. What three skills are key to succeeding in retail? I think the three skills that are essential right now in succeeding in retail, one is having the best in class technology stack. You have to make sure that your tech is not only helping you for right now, but is future proof for the next phase. So when someone comes with an idea, you can say that is possible. That's the first thing. The second thing is I think you need a strategy that puts you wherever your customers are. So if your customers are spending time on social media or in person or at farmers markets, that's where you have to show up. And most importantly, you have to have a best-in-class product. I have a small little side hustle called Firebelly Tea, which I started during the pandemic with my best friend, David. And we curate the best tea, but we also architect and design the best tea products. The reason we're doing that is because we don't just want to create another tea company. We want to create a product that exposes people to tea that have never been exposed to it before, introduces this new type of beverage to the world. And not only is the tea the best, but every single accessory from the travel mug to the strainer to the whisk for the matcha, we want it to be the very best of what it does. I think when you combine the best tech stack, the best strategy, and the best product, you end up with an incredible successful retail business. Tell us about a great manager you had and how they impact your career. Well, frankly, I think the best manager I've ever had was Toby Lutke, who's our CEO and founder at Shopify. When he brought me onto Shopify as an early employee, it fundamentally changed my entire life, but it also allowed me to help find my life's work. What Toby exposed to me was something that maybe I didn't see in myself. He saw something in me. He saw that sharp point, and he gave me the permission to spend decades. I'm in my second decade now, but I hope to be here for many decades. But he gave me the permission to spend decades perfecting that sharp point, which for me is really storytelling, telling the world why entrepreneurship and retail and commerce and Shopify are so important and frankly so remarkable. What do you do to stand out? I think to stand out in your career, often people say you need to be well-rounded, as I mentioned earlier, be very good at many things. But this goes back to what I said earlier. Instead of being well-rounded, I think you really need to be spiky. But there is one caveat. You need to make sure that you explain what your spikiness is, meaning you have to tell people, I want to be the best software developer. I want to be the best brand marketer. I want to be the best culinary chef. By telling people what your spiky object is that you're trying to perfect, it invites more people in to help you and to hold you accountable. And I think if you figure out what your unfair advantage is, what you're best in the world at, and you go really, really deep on that, I think that's how you succeed. I think that's how you win. What is the biggest risk you've taken in your career? Probably the biggest risk that I took in my career was I left a very stable income and a very consistent career path as a lawyer. I was working at a big law firm in Toronto, and I joined a small little startup in Ottawa, Canada called Shopify. And it was not obvious at the time that Shopify would end up where it is today, powering 10% of all e-commerce in the US. But I knew there was something special. In fact, I think the time to take those risks in your career is when you're early in your career, because frankly, the risk of failure is so close to zero. What qualities do you look for in people you hire? When I'm building my team, I look for people who are incredibly action-oriented, very ambitious. Ultimately, Shopify is the entrepreneurship company. So I expect everyone that comes in here to be a founder, to act like an entrepreneur, to be a self-starter, to be action-oriented, and for people who just don't take no for an answer. If we're gonna be the entrepreneurship company and we're gonna build software for other entrepreneurs, then the people that work here also need to be entrepreneurs. And so you'll notice across the 8,000 people or so that work at Shopify, so many of us have other businesses on the side or hobby businesses or side hustles, whatever you wanna call it. We love that. What is your leadership philosophy? My leadership philosophy is really how you do anything is how you do everything. And what I mean by that is intentionality really matters. This is a true story, I will put as much effort in working on what I say are, you know, what are quarterly earnings calls or closing a new partnership for Shopify as I will structuring an email to one of our merchants. I think intentionality, everything you do, and thoughtfulness really, really matters. And that idea of how you do anything is how you do everything, that's sort of has always been my philosophy. What innovations are you most proud of? I think the innovations I'm most proud of at Shopify, well, they're endless, I guess, but a few stand out. This year, we got empirical proof that Shopify has the best converting checkout on the planet. Actually, it converts 36% better than the competition. And one of the things that I love to say is that, you know, not being on Shopify is now a competitive liability. The thing about Shopify is that commerce is moving so fast, new trends, new ways to buy, new ways to check out. But we move faster, and whether it's bringing millions of businesses online overnight, or during the pandemic, for example, or building the tools they needed to sell during the pandemic, like curbside pickup, or putting the power of AI in the hands of everyday entrepreneurs with our new suite of AI tools we call Shopify Magic. We're constantly at the forefront of commerce and not just trying to figure out what people need now, but anticipating what they will need in the future. And that's what I'm most proud of. How do you turn off work and how do you encourage your team to find work-life balance? The thing about being an entrepreneur, or frankly, any ambitious person, is it's really, really hard to turn off. And for me, you know, I really do live and die by my calendar. So I've intensely focused time with whatever I'm doing. I put everything from the most important meetings at Shopify to even time with my wife and my two daughters, Bailey and Zoe. I put those into my calendar because I really want to make sure I'm focused on it. So no joke, I have walks with my wife, Lindsay, on my calendar, and I have, you know, go swimming with my kids on the calendar as well. If you really want to do something and it's important to you, calendarize it, diarize it, make sure you hold yourself accountable to it by making it obvious. What is the one job in retail most people would not associate with retail? Well, I think retail is so encompassing. Maybe one job in retail that most people would not associate with retail per se is working anything on the engineering side to build a really incredible tech stack or fulfillment delivery. You know, it's all part of the ecosystem of retail. And even though it may not seem like this is obvious that this is something needed for retail, if you look behind some of my most favorite brands on Shopify, Aloe Yoga, Viori, Gymshark, Allbirds, Figs, Skims, Kylie Cosmetics, Supreme. Ultimately, when you look behind those brands, what they will talk to you about is the product. They'll also talk to you about the tech stack that product was built on. And that's what I geek out on. I think that's some of the most exciting parts of retail. What is something unexpected about my career in retail? Maybe something that is unexpected is, as I mentioned, I went to law school, not to become a lawyer, but to become a better entrepreneur, which led to Shopify, which is making commerce better for everyone. You know, going to law school is not an obvious next step for what you'd want to do when you want to go into retail. But I think no matter what you're studying in school, you need to kind of put a lens on it to figure out, okay, law school is all, there's a lot of writing there. Can I use this class to become a better better writer. Law school taught me how to think more critically, how to debate. You know, there's this one Latin term called the ratio decidenti in law, which is if you're reading a 30 or a 300 page case, there's this one line that matters. It's the one main takeaway. Being able to sift through so much information in anything you do and pick up the one line that matters, I learned that in law school, and I apply that to so much in retail today. Maybe another one, as I mentioned, is this idea of moot court, which is kind of like debate club, the ability to understand and argue both sides of every argument. That is something that I learned in law school. So all these things have served me incredibly well in my career, and they were not obvious that law school would have been the place where I would have encountered them. What is the most rewarding part of your job? There's a lot. Probably the most rewarding part of my job is getting to meet the people who use Shopify, whether it's someone who is building a store on Shopify at their mom's kitchen table, or someone like Zulily or Daily Harvest who are coming replatforming to Shopify and seeing the impact that their business is going to have when they come over to Shopify. I love talking to the folks at Supreme on Thursdays at noon. As many of you may know, Supreme does the largest flash sales on the planet, 11 a.m. every Thursday. But talking to the team at noon after it's done and hearing the takeaways, it's so exciting for me. But also, that person who's sitting at the coffee shop right now, who are sitting in their you know, college library, who's at their mom's kitchen table, who's conceptualizing a new idea for a retail business, that is incredibly meaningful to me. What is one misconception about retail that you would love to debunk for everyone? I think the misconception I'd love every leader to stop doing is thinking of offline and online as different businesses or separate channels. The way we talk about retail needs to evolve. When you look at your business, it isn't online versus offline, it's retail everywhere. And we need to instead be asking, how are you reaching your customers? If your customers want to buy from you physically, that's how you should sell. But if some of them want to buy from you on Instagram, or they want to buy from you using the Shopify integration for Spotify, it's a lot of words, but we have that. And so you have to deeply think about, how can I be most empathetic towards how my customers want to purchase, and then make sure you're selling on those surface areas? How does your company and the retail industry overall impact people in every community every day? I think Shopify has unequivocally changed the landscape in retail. Think about your favorite brands, companies like Mattel or Skims, or again, your favorite local business that are powered by Shopify. What we've really tried to do is make entrepreneurship more common, more accessible, and reduce the barriers to success. We've made that possible, that if you have an idea in the shower in the morning, you're able to go ahead and take that idea and start a store by that same afternoon. We are the platform behind those brands, and we're trying to make commerce better for everyone every single day. I love the idea of hearing these stories of, you know, a hot sauce company or a barbecue company in a place like Mike D's barbecue sauce in Durham, North Carolina, that makes the most delicious barbecue sauce. Not only did Mike D start that sauce in his community, but now he's employing people in his community. He has a beautiful physical store where people can come in and try new products, but he also has a great online store. I mean, entrepreneurship is the ultimate way to create more community, create more jobs, and to facilitate a stronger economy. And I love that. What does the future of retail look like? I think I've been touching on that a little bit, but the future of retail looks like retail everywhere, across every surface, or on every channel, across every possible place where a consumer may want to make that purchase decision. And I think in many ways, this is the most exciting time of retail. You know, John Wanamaker created Wanamaker's Department Store in Philadelphia in 1876. And it was the first time that a department store was created. In fact, fun fact, that was also the first time there was a telephone in a commercial establishment. That model of department store, we've seen different iterations of it. It's grown, it's become more creative, more lights. Now there's water parks in some department stores. But it all was where you as a maker asked someone else to put your product on their shelf. And this idea of direct to consumer being this new incredible retail model is so exciting, because it means you can make something and you can sell it directly to the people that will consume it. What does it mean for me to be recognized by the NRF Foundation? It's incredibly, incredibly humbling and exciting for me. It's a huge honor. I don't know what else to say. I feel so lucky to be doing my life's work at Shopify in the retail industry, making commerce better for everyone, and also to be part of NRF. NRF was an organization that for the last 20 years, I've read their blog post, I've gone to their media center, I've gone to their events, and I looked up in awe of everything they did to advance retail and to advance the entire industry, and to play a small part of it today. It's incredibly meaningful to me. So I just want to say thank you to the NRF Foundation for this wonderful honor. And I promise I'm going to keep building the retail industry. I'm going to keep supporting every entrepreneur, every brand. And I think we are on the precipice of the most exciting time for retail ever. So I've enjoyed answering these 20 questions and sharing more about how I've built my career in retail. You can check out more insights with retail professionals, including episodes with honorees on the list of people shaping retail's future at nrffoundation.org. I'm Harley Finkelstein, president of Shopify. Thank you for watching. Harley out.